Hey, I'm Jordan from UX Tools, and today we're going to be doing something that I'm going to call a UX teardown of the Delta SkyMiles page. So SkyMiles is Delta's frequent flyer program. You build up miles by buying flights and spending money. So I was on my own SkyMiles page the other day, just checking out my profile and seeing what the status was. And I think this is a really good page to do a teardown on. What we're gonna do is a design critique of the page first, and then I'm gonna show you the changes that I would propose, and then we're just gonna talk about the main takeaways at the end. So I imported the page into Figma, and here it is. We're just gonna focus on this middle section for this teardown. So I think it's important to just pause for a second here and think about the user. Who are they and what is their task that they're trying to accomplish on this page? What is their job to be done? This is a Delta customer who's already purchased flights. They're coming here probably first to get some info, like what is the status of my SkyMiles? How many miles do I have to spend? What is the tier that I'm currently at? And then they probably want to know, how can I go ahead and use those miles? The business's goals are probably very similar. We want them to know what the status of their miles is. We want them to book trips with those miles. And we probably also want them to be made aware of other programs that they could join. So those are the design goals. And I think there are a few things about this page that kind of hinder those goals. For example, when you first land on this page, it feels very busy and honestly kind of overwhelming and a little confusing. So we know that that's going to get in the way of the task that the user is trying to accomplish here because of things like satisficing, which is where basically the user gets so overwhelmed that they just sort of give up looking at everything and they make the first decision that comes to mind. Or Hick's Law, which is where the number of visual stimuli increases the amount of time it takes to process information and make decisions. So a page that's confusing and isn't structured very well and doesn't have very much order is going to cause more user errors. It's going to lengthen out the time that a user needs to accomplish their task, and it's going to cause just a lot of friction. So let's walk through a couple of the reasons why this feels kind of busy and overwhelming. The first one is that there are a lot of visual signals going on. For example, look at all of the different buttons that we have. We have this type of open button. We have these buttons that have a gradient. We have this button that doesn't have a gradient. And then we have this button that is larger than the other ones. We've got a lot of text on this page and it doesn't feel like there's a clear hierarchy. The titles don't really stand out except for maybe this one at the top. There's lots of colors, weight differences, size differences. So there's a lot going on. It doesn't really feel like it has a purpose. We've even got some kind of strange things going on, like these boxes are different sizes and there's some sort of misalignment here. There's no standardization of the spacing between boxes. And then there's this box that sort of comes out a little farther than the other ones. This also doesn't follow Delta's new design system. I think this is probably just a leftover page that they haven't gotten to yet. But just as a basic example, you know, this dark blue is different than this dark blue. And the new design system uses the Whitney font. This old page uses the Open Sans font. So all of this type of stuff is just a little distracting for the brain. Our brains like order. And when order isn't present, then the brain sort of has to process those things instead of doing things like processing information and making decisions. So I think the first thing that we need to do is tighten things up a little bit visually and create more visual uniformity. There's quite a lot of information on this page, which is great because the user is coming here to get information. But some of it is duplicate information and a lot of it isn't grouped up very well. So remember, the law of proximity says that things that are close together, our brain can associate better and process better. So I think we need to tighten up the information a little bit also. I'll give you a couple of examples here. The first one is the SkyMiles member title. It's very big and there are two close together, which feels like duplicate information. I also don't know if we actually need this title, because we're already on the SkyMiles page, so there's kind of an assumption that we're looking at a SkyMiles member profile. Also, explore SkyMiles, membership guide and program rules, program details, earn miles, use miles, all of those go to very similar or the same page. So I think we can sort of simplify the number of links that go to information like that. And my recent activity, my account activity, and account activity all go to the same or similar pages. So I think we can simplify that as well. And finally, there are lots of actions you can take from this page. Like I said before, there are several buttons, all of which sort of look different. But I mean, there's no real hierarchy of what you should be doing, except for maybe book a trip because it has more spacing and so it draws your eye more. But there are buttons and links everywhere to all kinds of things. So I think we need to build a better structure about the calls to action and things that the user can do on this page. So now I'm gonna show you a pretty simple redesign that I did of this page based on the critique that we just did. First thing I did was I grabbed this header that is used on several other pages in the app that use the new design system, and I just put it on this page. At the top, we have right away probably the information that people are coming here most often to get, which is their SkyMiles number so that they can use it in orders, and the number of miles that you have available. Then I added this SkyMiles overview section. I widened the container so that we could have a little bit more room to work with. The initial page starts about here, but I think we can widen things up so that we have more space. This first box, and by the way, I got this box and all of these styles, including this button style, from their new design system. This first box is there to show you the information about the tier that you're currently at in your SkyMiles profile. I simplified these charts a little bit so that they're easier to understand. I got rid of the acronyms because I bet a lot of people don't know what the acronyms mean. So like before it had MQMs and I wrote that out instead of using the acronym. This is supposed to clearly show you how long it will take you to get to the next tier. So, you know, in this particular example, they have 22,000 miles left to get to the silver tier. And then I put some key links down here at the bottom that relate to, again, information, gathering information. And then over here on the right, this box is for what you can do with your miles, how you can use them. Obviously, the main use will probably be to book a trip. And we as the business also want them to book a trip. So that is highlighted at the bottom in a big button. And then, you know, these are the key links that allow you to use your miles in any other way that you can. I merged a lot of the links that we talked about before. And then finally, I took all of the calls to action to other programs and things like that that Delta had on that initial page, and I put them all down here at the bottom in these cards with these red arrows that, again, I grabbed from their design system and other places. So the general idea here is to give the user what they want and need first and then pitch them at the bottom in a much more standardized, clean way. So here is the before and here is the after. So you'll see that we tried to tackle a lot of the issues that we talked about in the critique. For example, there are a lot fewer visual signals going on. It feels much more spacious and a lot easier to process, less busy and less overwhelming. The information has been grouped. For example, this is where you get information about your SkyMiles. This is where you act on those SkyMiles. And these are all of the promotions that Delta is trying to pitch you. So information has been grouped. It's also been merged so that there is less duplicate information. And I think that there is a better hierarchy of actions to take on this page. Clearly, the most important action that draws your eye the most is to book a trip, which is what the user and the business will want the user to be doing on this page. So some of the main takeaways that we can use in any design are: group similar things together, get rid of duplicate information and actions, and reduce visual signals by using things like your design system everywhere on your app. And then finally, give the user what they want first before you ask for things from them. And make sure that you understand why they're on this page and what exactly they need to accomplish. And then help them achieve that task. We fixed some of the issues that we talked about in the critique, but this page is not perfect by any means. So let me know in the comments what else you would change. I'd love to get some feedback on these videos too. So if you think that this UX teardown was helpful or if we could do something better, you can also put that in the comments and we'll be sure to read everything. Thanks for watching. We'll get you in the next video.